Hey guys, welcome back to the Friday Vlog, where we discuss activity that goes on here with the BuzzWeaver channel. That includes things like current events, headlines that are in the news, pop culture, social media, technology, and items of interest that come up during the week that allow us to have a little bit of a dialogue. If this is your first time here to the channel, I'd like to welcome you guys here. If you are watching on DTube and or BitChute, I would ask you guys to give me a follow there as well. And for those of you here on YouTube, of course, down there in the bottom right-hand corner, that would be the channel icon to subscribe as well, along with notifications. That way you guys will know when there's content here on the channel, as well as the Friday Vlogs. In gaming news, this week in Call of Duty Modern Warfare, we have the updated playlist for Tuesday, another adjustment to the Ritech sniper rifle, and I was finally able to complete the officer challenges this week. So it was a very productive week, not a whole lot going on within the gaming community in and of itself. But nonetheless, guys, if you do want to check out the community news from last week, I'll leave a link up here for you in the top right-hand corner. Some of the biggest news from last Friday and into this week surrounds the Goya Food Company, whose president is Robert Unanue. And I wanted to read from the article before we go into the commentary. So the hashtag Goya Way was trending on social media Friday after Robert Unanue, CEO of Goya Foods, appeared in the White House Rose Garden Thursday afternoon and praised President Donald Trump. Now, he was invited, of course, to the White House there. And as is typically done, there's a sense of pleasantries and decorum that goes on there, which some people like to often accuse the president of being kind of uncouth, right? And so here we have kind of a diplomatic situation where the president of Goya was invited to the White House. And this is what he had to say. "We are all still truly blessed to have a leader like President Trump, who is a builder," Unanue said during the Rose Garden speech. "We have an incredible builder, and we pray. We pray for our leadership, our president." And that's exactly what he said that then set off Twitter. The fact that Unanue would associate with Trump was sufficient to anger some of the Americans' most prominent Hispanic leaders. Congresswoman Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez suggested in a tweet that she'd boycott Goya. Now think about this. In 2012, Mr. Unanue was invited to attend a function that Michelle Obama was having to promote her healthy foods. It was some initiative that she was working on, and of course, there was no particular controversy. But in 2020, if you align yourself with the president, of course, if you're not part of the fad that then goes after the president, or you're not part of the fad who denounces the president, or you're not part of the Trump detractor, then of course, you're obviously in opposition to the progressive movement. And these are the people that really have just come out on this. Now, you think about it, as he said, now, the president of Goya went on Fox News and explained exactly what I just told you. In 2012, he was invited by Michelle Obama to be part of her healthy food initiative. And of course, then there was no particular controversy whatsoever. As a matter of fact, during the Obama administration, we didn't see any of this cancel culture. You didn't see conservatives or the right wing or independents or Green Party or anybody forming these types of cancel cultures, these marches, these rallies, these rioting that we're seeing here. None of this was going on during the time of Obama. If we had an issue with Obama, we talked about the particular policies or whatever measures and other things that he was trying to introduce, we would go after the content of what he was trying to do as a president and not going after him necessarily as a human being because of some superficial scruples that we had about him. But nonetheless, Goya Food doubled down. They did not apologize. They're not going to apologize, and they shouldn't. And as a matter of fact, it looks like their food sales has gone up, and a lot of people are very supportive of the president of Goya, because there wasn't anything in particular about what he did that would seem unusual. I mean, we have dignitaries and foreign leaders who come to the United States who essentially say about the same thing he did, not to mention all the companies and businesses that are out there that have been helping with the current pandemic as well. And there was no particular outrage there. But the fact that this individual simply made very complimentary pleasantries, having been invited to the Rose Garden to speak, suddenly he's some sort of villain like they accuse President Trump of being. And it's unfortunate to see this, so people can kind of see the cancel culture now. If you're not in line with these groups of individuals, then obviously there's something wrong with you as an individual. You're not on board with the opposition towards the president. And of course, you can't like the president because he's any number of particular insults that they constantly try to call him. But nonetheless, guys, I will leave links below this video if you guys want to check out some of the details of the story concerning this particular issue. On Wednesday, all across social media and across the news, we saw the story of Twitter having been hacked. So let's read from the article before we go into the commentary. Twitter is removing images from the social media network that could point to how attackers executed a major hacking spree on the platform on Wednesday. Hackers took over the Twitter accounts of prominent users including Barack Obama, Bill Gates, Elon Musk, Kanye West, and Jeff Bezos in order to promote a Bitcoin scam. So this individual essentially got a hold of the accounts and then apparently had asked individuals to click on a link that would then, or the individuals such as Bill Gates would then pay them $2,000 if they gave their Bitcoin account. And then this individual went in and then of course was able to steal money from them via Bitcoin. So while Twitter hackers are nothing new, the social media network experiences frequent account takeovers. The repeated and singular theme on Wednesday's account takeover suggested an effort beyond the simjacking attack that ensnared Twitter CEO Jack Dorsey last August. Now, of course, it's not unusual for these types of companies to get DDoS and other types of hacks. But of course, when individuals can find these types of vulnerabilities, they will exploit them, of course. And most of the time behind it, there's usually just the ability of them to be able to do it and not as nefarious, just to create irritation and annoyance for companies and businesses. We see this quite often, especially in the gaming community. For example, Blizzard will get DDoS attacks quite often. And basically, that's just a series of traffic that is rushed to the site to kind of slow everything down and just make it difficult for people to log in. But nonetheless, of course, this was a bit of an extortion involved here where people were extracting money, or this individual is extracting money by using these prominent accounts to then cause people to say, oh, well, it's from a legitimate authorized individual. So basically, Twitter had to shut down all the blue check marks. That's the verified people that are on the accounts. And many jokes have been made about, you know, having the blue check mark and the Twitterazzi and all the things that we have talked about here on the channel. But nonetheless, that was a major issue for the Twitter brand. But of course, one might even say that it was President Trump that actually enabled Twitter to come back to life again, because it was a dying platform until the president got on there. And of course, we all know the echo chambers of the media that are on there, who kind of collaborate with one another and feed off one another's tweets and posts. And this is where some of these cancel culture, or obviously where the cancel culture gets together to be able to go after people like Goya or the president or whatever their particular format and narrative is for the day or for the week or whatever it is that they're doing. But nonetheless, it was a major issue there for Twitter, but they essentially just had to shut down all the accounts, verified accounts. My account wasn't affected, of course, because I'm not verified, but nonetheless, it was an interesting event that happened, and I'll leave links to that below this video. All right, guys, so that's going to wrap up for this Friday vlog. I want to thank all you guys for your continued participation here on the channel. And if you are following on DTube and or BitChute, this is where you see your normal Friday vlogs, I would ask you guys to give me a follow there as well. And I want to thank all you guys for your continued support on those platforms. And of course, if you are here on YouTube, that would be the channel icon appearing right there on the screen to subscribe, along with clicking notifications. That way you guys will know when there is content here on the channel, as well as the Friday vlogs. And I'll see you guys right there behind the camera next week.